These here are the parts that wear out. If you look right here, there's a little cutout on the side. You see it, little indention there on the side? That's where that goes. Right in that little indention. This is an old one. It's kind of beat up, wore out. We're going to put new ones of these in. Don't lose this washer on the end. Very, very important. Inspect the teeth while we're here. These are the gear spacers. This was a 5-speed. I made it a 3-speed. Those two spacers take up 4th and 5th gear. Simple matter of putting some grease on the shaft. I can't tell if this is a new one or an old one. This is a new one. Same thing on this side, clean your washer off real good. Slide the washer on there. A little bit of slick them up. Slide your new bushing on there. This one is ready to go back in. Almost. Kind of in a blue mood today, so got red grease, so use blue gasket sealer. Probably gonna use white aniseed. Anyway, these little triangles here. You can see that little triangle there. Those sit in that little triangle cutout there. I'm going to do the output shaft. Do the output shaft and then I'll get back to y'all. Show y'all something. This is why I do this. Look at that. I'd rub it on my bushing. Cause my bushing to fail. Let's cause that on my output shaft. I think we're gonna be okay, but Still not good. That's why I do these tear downs. I gotta go dig through my bucket of parts and find another one of these. Alright, I found another one. I'm gonna take one out of another used transmission that I had. This is a spacer that eliminates the reverse in these things. There's the fourth, fifth gear spacers. Chicken teeth look okay. The way this thing shifts is this here rides on here like this and slides between these different gear sets. And if you can see it, there's a little hump right there. That's what engages your gears. Same thing with this one as I did with the other one. This pretty much rinse and repeat. This is one of my pet peeves right here. People don't take the time to make their work look nice. Drop it in here. Line your marks up there on your chicken fork. Looks in good shape. Looks to be in good shape. That goes in that groove well. That goes in that groove there. There's an indention in the bottom that sits in. Get you a good 80 or 90 weight gear oil to put in there. I go a quarter of a way up the gear. Hey, y'all, we got our siliconed up. these bolts. I just snug them down with my impact. Come back with a ratchet. When you strip one of these off, that's a bad deal. Because your lowercase is just about run. Just kind of zigzag back and forth. Just want a good firm pressure on it. Have I mentioned I hate seeing silicone oozing outside something? This. This is lawnmower's equivalent. Lawnmower racing's equivalent to a quick change rear end in a race car. Put that on there. Pardon the train, y'all. It's noisy here where I live. Held on with a simple snap ring. This is a 12 tooth, 40 pitch, quick change sprocket. Put it on there like that. Take snap ring. Make sure it seats, and there you go. I'm done. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. I'm gonna get the frame and stuff cleaned up and go back in with this thing. Y'all just bring it.